Hey guys, we are going to talk about the lefty grip today. So, to show you kind of what I mean, first let me tell you where I'm sitting. So, this paper is kind of perpendicular to me right now, so that the camera angle is straight for you, but it's on an angle for me. I'm sitting like this at my desk. The paper's a little bit off to the right because that works best for me. So, when people are asking me about lefty grip, I can't get started doing brush lettering because I hold my pen in a certain way. I don't know which way the lefties are supposed to hold the pen. I can't quite get it. I'm here to help. If you've seen my videos or anything that I do on Instagram, you know that I hold the pen really weird. So when I teach people, I kind of have to do a disclaimer of, do as I say, not as I do. Because the truth with the lefty grip is, you're really not going to change your normal writing grip that much. So, if you hold the pen like this when you're writing in a normal way, you're probably going to still hold the pen in a similar way. Likewise, if you do some funny pen tuck like this, you're probably going to retain that and do something similar. If you have this overhanded grip, more like this, you're going to do that. So, when I write like this, with all five fingers. It's completely weird. I know this. I paint like this, with three fingers like you're supposed to. But when I write, I like it to be more vertical, and I end up with four or all five fingers on. So I'm gonna go through this because it's part of what I was doing when I was teaching myself the right way to do this. So, the grip is not the key. The grip doesn't matter. How you hold the pen, you're kind of going to hold the pen. What matters is the angle that you're holding it and knowing how you hold it, if that makes sense. So, let's get started. Okay, so if you want to get to my resources, like this blank guide sheet, I give these kind of things away for free on my blog, and the blog's available at missybriggs.com. Also, you can get to my resources through Instagram. I usually have all my links up there at M2B Studio. So the grip is not what we're really talking about, but I will go through the grips because I tried a bunch. I tried to hold the pen in different ways when I was getting started, just to kind of get my bearings, and I realized, it kind of doesn't matter. And in the end, it's how you're holding the paper and how you position the paper. So let's go through a couple of different ways that people hold their pen when they're left-handed. And I know we're all different, so there are other ways that people tend to do this. Okay, so first, there's the overwriter. Sometimes people call this the hook grip. Usually the pen is angled back towards you. I have a hard time emulating this because sometimes when I write and I'm doing something difficult, I will actually get into a position where I'm kind of more like this. So the overwriter is kind of hard for me to imitate. But nevertheless, what the overwriter does is there, if this is the baseline that you're writing on, this one, then they're kind of over it and kind of hooked around. So that's why it's called sometimes a hook grip or an overwriter grip. And a lot of times, again, not always, overwriters find it beneficial to turn their paper away from them. So they're actually kind of writing upward instead of downward. So the most important thing when you're trying this is to realize that when you're doing brush lettering, your strokes upward are going to be thin, and the strokes downward are going to be thick. So the real key, again, I'm not an overwriter, so it's kind of hard for me to illustrate this, but I'm trying. The real key is getting this pen to an angle that's going to allow you to make this downstroke thicker like that. So an overwriter, while you're sitting normally, it's kind of hooked like this. When I've turned my paper, now the pen angle kind of goes along with this 52 degree angle that I've created on the guide sheet. So that if you're writing an oval, it will naturally follow that you can push down at the appropriate place. Again, an upward stroke and a downward stroke really makes sense when you're holding the paper at this kind of an angle. I'm not an overwriter, trying my best, and I'm holding it in a tripod grip, which is not my grip. Now an under, so they may find it beneficial to do that. Again, some overwriters just will go sideways like this and find the best way. There are overwriters that do go in this direction, and I call them right-handed, because essentially what they're doing is the same motion that a right-handed person would do. Does that make sense? If you're holding the pen and it's actually turning and the pen angle is going away from you like this, you're right-handed, because when you make an upstroke, it's going away. And even though you're physically pushing it, it's doing the same motion that a right-handed person would be doing this way. I've seen it. There are less people that write like that, but I've seen it. Now, an underwriter comes from underneath the baseline. So if you're trying to write on this line as your baseline, you start writing from here. And usually you have maybe the tripod grip, maybe you hold it kind of funny, you do that or something. But the direction that you're coming from is underneath the baseline, and you're pushing up from underneath and coming down. Well, if you don't change your paper angle, what's going to happen when you do this is you're not going to be able to create this thick line when you're coming downward. So underwriters tend to, not always, turn the paper more towards them. So now, remember, I'm sitting like this. My paper is really turned like this. And some of them turn it all the way towards this 90 degree. Because when you're coming from under, but now I've turned my paper, I'm going to be able to make that oval with a nice downward stroke. Again, I'm not an underwriter per se either. I'm kind of a side writer. But do you see what I'm saying? That this downward stroke is now this kind of sideways stroke. And I'm able to create the ovals going this way. That was a really bad one. This way down and back up. So besides the overwriters and the underwriters, there's the lefties like me. We're kind of like a side writer. And our main issue is smudging and smearing. Let's go over that. So if you're more a side writer like me, you have the issue of smearing, because I hold the pen funny, I know, but I hold it and I go straight across the paper like this. So while my paper is turned just a little bit, what's happening is every time I lay down some ink, I risk running my hand through it. If I'm making a series of ovals, as I go along, you have a choice. You're either going to wait, you're going to do some weird hovering thing, or you're going to start adjusting your grip so you don't get into a puddle. I suggest either waiting or getting another piece of paper and covering your tracks and keeping it under your hand. Now the paper's still going to pick up the ink here and there, so this isn't the best solution. I've been known to go backwards when I write. People ask me if I do that on purpose. But the truth is, these basic strokes that I do, especially if I'm writing lowercase, You can go backwards once you get the strokes down. I do not suggest you go backwards. Sometimes I do it when I'm painting a project and I'm in a jam, but for the most part, I go forward just like everyone else. So again, the side writing, you're coming at it from an angle, you're pushing. That's the difference really between the lefties and the righties. We're pushing the pen across the page. So when righties are pulling this thin upstroke up and able to get this perfectly thin upstroke that seems effortless, we are either coming from below or on the side, pushing it, which can be awkward. So we're talking about pushing, pulling, overrider, underrider. Really, if you're just getting started, I recommend that you start using not this big pen, but really a smaller felt-tipped brush pen. And you can get free blank guides from missybriggs.com. I also sell traceable guides on Etsy. You can always get tips from me on Instagram at MTB Studio. I'm showing you today using this larger brush pen because it's easier for you to see when you're getting started, just to take a look at how these marks are made when you're able to see up close the way that this is angled like this, what part of the pen you want to use when you're making your mark. Hint, it's right here. Not that tip. And kind of understand the mechanics behind it. I recommend getting started with a smaller tip because if you're getting confused and you're even thinking about doing some of these weird motions, you're going to tend to not do that with a smaller brush tip pen. When you're doing this larger one and you're saying, oh, I want to make an oval, but I don't know how to make this part thicker right here. Sometimes people start doing things, twisting their wrist in order to get this kind of what seems like an unwieldy tip to go the direction they want it to go. So I just think it's easier to get started using the small pens. If you want to use the larger brush pens, that's fine. These larger guide sheets that I have available for free are also great for using with a number two size brush if you're interested in doing lettering with watercolors or something like this, a nylon tipped brush. I'd just say overall, don't be concerned with the lefty grip and how you hold it. I mean, I hold it like a toddler and I'm successful. I'm a professional lettering artist. This is what I do as my full-time job. I would be more concerned with placement of your paper, angles of the paper, playing around with what feels most comfortable to you, and have fun with it. If you have any questions, leave them in the comment section and I will help you out in my next video.